know, spreadsheets were first developed for accounting, and accounting, by nature, looks backward, recording what already happened. One of the most dangerous mistakes when building a CRM in a spreadsheet is using it only to record the past. CRM stands for Customer Relationship Management, and relationships constantly evolve. So your CRM, even in a spreadsheet, should be forward-looking. But what does this look like? This video is a quick overview of a simple and forward-looking CRM spreadsheet. See for yourself what the difference it can make for your business growth. So this is the free CRM spreadsheet that you can download by following the link in the video description. When you copy the file, the first thing that you will see is your action stream. And in the action stream, you will see all of your contacts, but they are sorted by their due dates. And these due dates are your follow-up reminders. You can see that they are also color-coded. So the overdue ones, they are in red. The ones that are scheduled for today are in orange, and all the future ones are in gray. You can always sort your contacts by alphabet, but this is not very convenient because, for example, it doesn't matter if D comes before B, because I need to follow up with Ruby on the 6th of October, so my action with Joe is not as urgent as my follow up with Ruby. In the template, you can see that all of these dates have formulas. This was done so that no matter on which day you download the template, you will still see some of the overdue actions, some of the actions scheduled for today, and some for the future. But once you download the template, you can always customize it. For example, let's say that I want to check in with Katrine today. So I can change this to the 16th of October 2024. I press enter, and then the date is highlighted in orange. So what I can do now is just sort the action stream, and this is just a reminder for you so that if you do any accidental change that it doesn't save straight away, so you can always check this to not show you for 5 minutes. Then I press on OK, and all of the actions are sorted again, and I can see that for today I have 3 actions. The great thing about Google Sheets is that it's quite interactive compared to Excel. So for example, here you will be able to switch between different views. See contacts only with actions, so all of your contacts that don't have actions will not be shown here. Then you can also go to contacts without actions. This is great because sometimes I can add a contact and they just forget adding a next action to it. So by going into this view, I can change some of the contacts and set next actions for them. For example, let's say that with Tess, it would be great to touch base before the end of the year. So I'll put December 2024 just to make sure that I check in with Tess. There is also another view that's called focus mode. The focus mode helps you to focus only on the things that are urgent, so that all of your attention goes to the most important tasks. And once you're ready, you can just exit the view. And for example, let's imagine that I already asked Ruby about her plans for the next quarter, so I can set another action for the future date, like 9th of December 2024, and I'll just change it to send a follow-up reminder. Done, and then I just sort all of my actions. The great thing about this template is that you don't need to edit too many things. So of course you can customize it further. You can see that the status here and also another column project stage, they are drop-down lists. So you can have different options here. But not everyone needs project stages. Some people prefer to have deal stages, or they call them sales deals. So you can always customize it to fit your business needs. So you just click on the edit button here, and then you have different stages that you can change to whatever fits you better. Another thing that you can do in Google Sheets, you can click on extensions, go to add-ons, manage add-ons, and there will be different add-ons available. You can try to find the add reminders add-on. Once you add it to your Google Sheets, then you can go to, you will see in the extensions, there will be add reminders. You can go to add reminders, set up reminders, and add a new reminder. And then you can see that the spreadsheet recognizes that the due date column, it has dates. So you can set a reminder 1 day in advance and then notify me, so the email will be sent to your Gmail account. Once you do this, you just click on done. And it is saved, so This means that the reminder will go to you one day in advance before the action date. And then you will see reminder sent. So it means that the reminder was sent to your Gmail account. This is good for those of you who do not plan to use the spreadsheets on a daily basis. Let's see how it looks. Go to your Gmail account and you receive an email. In this email, you will see the date of the reminder, then some information about the person that you need to be in touch with, and also a link to your spreadsheet, so you can always click on the spreadsheet and go back to your file. The only sheets that you need to edit in this template is the action stream. So this is where everything happens. So you can add new columns, you can add more rows. The other sheets that are available in this spreadsheet, they are for you, just for your reference. For example, the overview tab just shows you what happens in your CRM spreadsheet. The report date is calculated automatically, so you can see that the date is set for today. So every day that you open the spreadsheet, the date will change automatically. You don't need to do anything. You will see your total progress. This is the overview of your projects or sales deals, depending on how you name them. The workload is another important part of your work because it can show you if you are behind too many tasks. Then you also have your pipelines, and I also can see my total revenue from this spreadsheet. The calculation tab is another tab that you don't need to change. These are all formulas, so they are calculated automatically. The spreadsheet takes information from your action stream and then gives them a graphical representation. And you will also see instructions, but the instructions, it's just a link to the video that you are currently watching, or you can also go to the blog post that we have published on our website, where we go into more detail about how the spreadsheet works and also provide a few more examples if you want to try some other spreadsheets before committing to one of them.
Simple, color-coded, and fast. But as your business grows, you have more complex operations and a bigger client database. So you will want to keep everything in one place: invoices, meeting notes, client emails, projected revenue, and so on. That's where even the greatest spreadsheet hits its limit and businesses start looking for a proper CRM. Transitioning from a spreadsheet to a CRM can be challenging, but there is another problem. Not a lot of CRMs are forward-looking. They were designed to store and organize information rather than to encourage you to put it into action. So let me present to you OnePage CRM and why it makes the transition from a spreadsheet to a proper CRM so easy.
So this is OnePage CRM. What I did is just I imported the contacts that I have in my spreadsheets into OnePage CRM. And you can see that here I also have the action stream. It's also color-coded, so all of my contacts, they have the reminders next to them. But it is much more interactive than the spreadsheet. For example, I can move them around if I want and just focus on some of them. I can also click to change the date very easily and just navigate between different dates. I can also refresh the page, so if I want to go back to what was before, and I can see at a quick glance the status of my contacts. In the spreadsheet, I had to go to the dashboard to see this, but here I can see everything in my action stream. I can also see the tags. For example, I have only one VIP contact. That's also fine. If you have more, that's great. I can have a quick look at how many contacts I have for each company. For example, there are 3 contacts in this organization. I can also see which of the contacts have pending deals. I can even filter them. For example, I can click on pending deals and then my action stream will show only the contacts that have some ongoing deals or projects that I can work on. I can then just close this filter and then back to my action stream. I can also add a target widget for myself. This is just a quick reminder for me so that I keep track of my goals and I always hit them. With OnePage CRM, you don't need to set up any add-ons. OnePage CRM will automatically send you a reminder every single morning about everything that you have to do for the day. So I'll show you how it looks. This is the morning email that you received from OnePage CRM. It shows you the actions that you have for today, some of your overdue actions, well, I have quite a lot of them, then you have pending deals, and then you have also the sales summary for the month. If, for example, you don't use OnePage CRM for sales, you can always turn off the setting, so you will be receiving morning emails only with next actions, overdue and scheduled for today.
Similar to the spreadsheet, you can also use a focus mode in OneTH CRM. So you just click here, click on what you want to hide. For example, I want to hide any contacts that don't have a next action. I can also hide any contacts that have future dates, so they have either tasks scheduled for today or they have overdue tasks. Unlike the spreadsheet, you can open each contact and see the details of all the interactions that you had with them. So you can click on the toggle view and then have your action stream next to the contact page. Or you can just remove the toggle view and go straight into the contact page. You can see all of the information about this contact, their LinkedIn profile, their company, contact details, any background information. You will also have next actions. And if you scroll down, there are also different integrations available. So if I connect my account to Aircall or, for example, PayPal or QuickBooks, then I will be able to see here all the calls and invoices that I send to Jane. Another thing that I can see on the contact page is if Jane is associated with other contacts in this organization. For example, there is Nina Crump that works also for a big company, so I can go straight to Nina's profile from Jane's profile. And I can see that I don't have any next action scheduled for Nina. I can see that I want to talk to her about strategy development, but we didn't have any communication yet. So I can send her an email straight from OnePage CRM. I just go to send email, then I connect my email address in just a few clicks. So I allow the full to email sync. I click on connect, and then I can send Nina a quick email. I can use email templates if I have ones. I don't have many templates, so I can just write an email to Nina and say hi. I can track this email, so I will see if Nina opened it and when she did it. I can also schedule it for later, but since I already have this pending deal, I want to send it right now. So what I do, I just click on send. And the email is sent, and all the communication that I had with Nina, I can always see on the contact page. Another thing that I can do from OnePage CRM is prepare for my call with Nina. For example, we will be discussing strategy development. I can go into this pending deal, and then I can just insert different services that I want to offer her. So I want to offer her a free consultation. And since we will talk about strategy development, I can edit straight away. I can also, during the call, discuss with her if there are any other options that she's interested. So maybe they want to have executive coaching or some budgeting done. Then I can present to her different bundles that I have. I have a premium bundle where I have all the services that I offer to my clients. Or I can offer her to go with a basic bundle, which includes a market research, audit and efficiency review. But for now, since I want to talk about strategy development, I'll just add these two items to the deal, and OnePage CRM automatically calculates the price. So I just click on save, and then everything is updated so I can see the final price for this deal. So I've already sent an email to Nina, but I can see that there is no next action scheduled for her. It means that if she doesn't reply, I might forget about this, so I just add a quick reminder for myself to give Nina a call. And since I sent her an email today, let's say that on Friday, if she doesn't reply, I'll give her a quick call. The email that I sent to Nina, it's available in the email inbox. So I can go to all emails and can see that I sent her an email. If I have several people on my team and they connect their email addresses to OnePage CRM, then only emails to and from CRM contacts will be synced to this inbox. It means that my personal communication will not end up in OnePage CRM, which is a great way just to keep track of all the emails that I have with my clients, leads, or prospects. Besides Nina, I have a few other clients with different ongoing projects and sales deals, so I can go also to my pipeline and have a quick overview of what's happening. In the sales pipeline, you can just move the deals around. So for example, let's say that Nina, when she gets back to me and I arrange a meeting with her, I can move the deal very quickly to the next stage. And another thing about OnePage CRM is all of the things that are happening in your CRM, they are automatically recorded and you can quickly see them in the dashboard. So you can see how many contacts you have, how many open deals, pending deals,
and then the activity that is happening in your CRM account.
That was a quick overview of one-page CRM. So to recap, a simple spreadsheet might be enough for your business for now. And when your business becomes bigger, you might want to upgrade to a CRM. But no matter which platform you use, you need to organize your contacts into an action stream rather than a contact reservoir where rows just keep piling up without generating much value for your business. Long gone are the days of backward-looking solutions. Your business will grow much faster if you treat contacts as assets rather than liabilities.